Mr. Speaker, I want to take the opportunity today to speak directly on behalf of my constituents and their concerns. Each year, I make a point to host a town hall in all 63 counties of the Big First District because visiting with and listening to Kansans, who I've taken an oath to serve, is one of the greatest joys of my work as a member of Congress. So far in 2022, I've hosted 7 of these town halls, and at each meeting, I heard the same concerns echoed: government spending, labor shortages, vaccine mandates, and the next farm bill. Kansans believe that government spending is out of control, and I agree with them. One of our country's fastest growing expenses is just the interest payments on our national debt, which is estimated to be $562 billion for fiscal year 2021 alone. You could fund the entire Department of Agriculture more than twice over for that amount. Given the situation, this administration's spending, as we've seen in the bloated Build Back Better plan, is short-sighted and dangerous. While discretionary government spending has weakened our great country, and not only that, spending on some programs during the pandemic has incentivized staying at home instead of returning to work. Kansans believe that labor shortages are hurting Americans, and I agree with them. People can't find bus drivers to take their kids to school or sanitation workers to pick up their trash. Meanwhile, inflation is at a 40-year high. Grocery store staples are up over 12%, and people's essential goods like car parts and refrigerators are still stuck in cargo ships. We're in an economic crisis, and this administration is yet to act meaningfully to combat the effects. Kansans believe that vaccine mandates are unconstitutional, and I agree with them. Anyone who wants to get a vaccine should be able to get one in this country, but it's not the federal government's job to dictate personal health care choices of American people. Vaccine mandates are a terrible idea for the present situation in this country, and they will only continue to strip the workforce of even more people. Kansans are also worried about the next farm bill, particularly as it relates to crop insurance and the livestock indemnity program, and I share these concerns. The 2018 Farm Bill did not include any major changes to federal crop insurance, which provides a robust and a strong safety net for farmers across the country. I also want to ensure that the livestock indemnity program remains intact, as it offered critical support to folks in my district after natural disasters like the recent wildfires that we saw last month. Farmers and producers are rightfully concerned that the 2023 Farm Bill could see significant changes. However, given that fact, House Democrats have held 0 Farm Bill implementation hearings so far. My goal is to do everything within my power for my constituents to ensure that no significant changes are made to reduce either of these essential components in the next Farm Bill. The new year, which has just begun, brings with it a hope for change and growth. If we've been dissatisfied with the course of our lives or that of our nation, January ushers in a fresh start. It gives us an opportunity to examine ourselves and to reassess our goals and ambitions. Most of all, the new year reminds us of the greatest privileges we have, living in a free nation where we have the right to life, liberty, and to pursue happiness as we see fit. And as we begin the second year of the 117th Congress, I want to reiterate my dedication to serving my constituents in the Big First. I'm fighting to preserve the foundation of our free nation and to protect your values. Kansas is still the pilot light of freedom for America, and as long as it continues to burn, I believe that our brightest days are yet to come. And Mr. Speaker, I stand